E aí, galera que está ligada aqui na Rádio The Rock Brasil, beleza? Hoje temos o prazer de estar aqui com a Laura Guldemond, vocalista da banda Burning Witches. Laura, how are you?
Hi, yeah, I'm good. How are you?
Good. A bit crazy. I mean, crazy, like, busy running from here to there, but now it's great.
Oh, good. All right.
Laura, I remember when I met you and Larissa, it was last year, you guys playing in Austria, Vienna at the Viper Room, I remember. Right? And then after that, you did like, you girls actually did a lot of tours. But first of all, I want to ask you something. How you got in the band?
Well, they were looking for a new singer because the other singer was kind of stuck in a cult at some point. So yeah, that was the story actually. Well, part of the story anyway. And yeah, they needed someone to fit, you know, they wanted someone that liked the same music that inspired them, you know, to do what they do. And I actually had a cover online. I mean, I had a few covers online, but one of them is Touch of Evil from Judas Priest back in the days. It's, I think it's still online somewhere. And I really am a Judas Priest fan, and there are more, you know, old school heavy metal bands that I like, and they could see that I liked it, and also that, you know, everything already fitted a bit for the first gig that I got with them then, because at first I went to an audition and it was like an unofficial gig, but it was kind of, you know, to check how it went. And so yeah, they knew I would fit, and I basically even put on an old outfit I had, you know, for on stage. It already fitted, so
Awesome. And then how did you get in the music or in the music itself, actually?
yeah, well, I did really love guitars, to be honest. So this is why I ended up with metal, I guess, because I just, you know, and I love that. Yeah, this whole time period of old school metal where guitars basically started to be super big, and you had all the, yeah, the cool solo artists also coming from, like, you know. Yeah, I just wanted to be part of that, I guess. So I tried to play guitar, but eventually I was better at singing, to be honest. So I turned out to be a singer, and it was just, I had a lot of his, you know, vocalists as inspiration that kind of made me jealous. Like, I wanted to be able to sing like that. And started practicing until I ended up in Ring Witches, I guess. So yeah,
Not
current
bad,
state of
not
how things are.
and talking about now. About the tours from last year, because I remember, as I said before, I met the band in Viper Room in Austria, Vienna, and then after that, I remember you girls are going to South America and North America, right? If you can tell me about it or tell us about it.
It was really cool. We were there for the first time, both in America and South America. So yeah, lots of new impressions, and it was really cool also to meet the fans for the first time that already were, you know, some of them were waiting for a few years already, right, to see us finally. So it was fun. Yeah, it was great. And yeah, we went to
São
yeah,
Paulo,
Brazil
Rio,
indeed.
Brazil. How was like, because I saw some pictures, you girls in São Paulo, I think Rio as well, you know, like going t-shirts, like in the sun, like being happy, and I was like, wow. Because I remember talking to you girls before I asked, hey, have any chance to go to Brazil or South America? Girls like, well, you know, let's see. And then you girls went there. How was like playing for them? How was the vibe of the people?
Yeah, it was good. I mean, yeah, they're really nice, and yeah, I mean, like I said, a lot of fans were really happy we finally played there, and I think we got along well with the Destruction fans also in the end. So we had a lot of fun playing for everyone, and yeah, we had a good time.
And I remember you girls did, or Burning Witch did the tour with Nervosa, right?
Oh yeah, Nervosa was Europe, yeah.
Was in Europe. So in South America, the girls didn't do
Destruction. Yeah.
destruction.
Yeah. And in America it was the Iron Maidens. Yeah.
Oh, tell me about it, because I mean I love the band as well. How was like, because it's the first time Nervosa. I'm sorry, not Nervosa. Burning Witch. I have Nervosa in my head. Burning Witch is went to United States, right?
Yeah, for the first time, yeah, it was fun. I mean, it was a pretty heavy tour, as in because it's the first time so far abroad, we didn't really have our own crew, so we had a crew we didn't know yet, you know, so it was all a bit figuring it out on the go, and you have a jet lag the first week, and then you just hope you can trust people to do their job, you know, like, oh, I hope it's going all right this evening, you know, this was a bit, yeah, everyone was just dead the first week, of course, obviously, but then, I mean, it's a whole new experience, right, to do it like that. And, but we had also a lot of fun also with the Iron Maidens and you know their crew also, you know, that everyone really helped us out too. And yeah, it was fun. We had a good good run.
And how was like, because as you said, it was the first time in the United States. How was the crowd? The fans already knew the band, or and how was the whole thing like jump there? I mean, after of course the jet lag, arriving there, getting there, and say, all right, girls, let's rock.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, it was really cool. Yeah, we definitely you know, it's nice to finally, you know, meet some people that wanted to meet you for a long time, but also to meet new fans, right? So we played M3 Festival, and well, that was, wait, when was that? I'm confused now myself. That was okay, that was the beginning, I think, and then after another, I think I'm not sure anymore what happened when. Oh, I'm really not good at this, man. But anyway, yeah, we played a few cool festivals too. We actually met Ingrid Malmsteen also, which was cool, just shortly, but it was cool. And actually, a fan made that happen because Ingrid doesn't really usually do that. So a fan actually paid him to meet us. That was pretty crazy. So thanks,
Oh,
I guess.
crap.
Yeah, it was pretty crazy. But yeah, pretty American, I guess, too. I mean, yeah, it is. It's the rock star life, I guess, right? So it's
True.
funny. There's more, like, for some reason, we play there more with hard rock than with metal bands. Yeah, so I'm really, really surprised about
Interesting.
that myself, to be honest. Yeah, the most
Interesting.
metal we played with is the Iron Maidens, I think.
And
Yeah.
how was playing? I mean, how was sharing the stage with these girls? Because I know, I mean, I love them as well. You know, they, for me, like, you know, they play really well.
It was fun. It was really fun. Yeah, I love the eddy they have. They had an eddy, you know, that goes. So at some more point, I think one of the last shows, Lala put on the eddy suit, and we went to on stage to have
Holy
a little party in
shit.
the eddy suit. Yeah, it was fun. I mean, they're just, yeah, they're nice, and they're really indeed a cool show. Yeah, it sounds great. They obviously play really good. It's not easy what they play, you know. So yeah.
I hear you. And
Yeah.
Laura, now I know like last year the band changed labels, right? From Nuclear Blast, you now the band signed with Napalm Records.
Yeah.
So why this change? Because I remember like your girls said to me, no, now we would Napalm Records, and I was like, interesting.
Yeah, indeed. Nuclear Blast got bought by a French company during that time that didn't really had a lot of physical you know, storage room. So yeah, and we actually love to have these special editions and everything in a different color, you know what I mean? So it's, yeah, it wasn't really going to happen. Yeah, basically the old school mentality there.
I
Yeah.
got you. I got you. Say no
Yeah,
more.
so
I got you. And the good thing is there's a new label, right? I mean, I'm sorry, new label. There's a new album. Why I'm thinking about label. There's a new album
I don't
called
know.
The Dark Tower.
Yeah.
And also like two singles. I mean, I saw the videos and I was like, holy crap, this is good. One of the singles is the name of the album, The Dark Tower. The other one, Unleash the Beast. All right, let's talk about the singles first, and then we'll talk about the album. Let's start with the Unleash the Beast. Who wrote the lyrics and who composed the whole thing, and also the video? Where did you girls record the video? So I mean, walk us through the whole thing.
Yeah, sure. It was fun. It was like, to be honest, it was one of those, the last songs we edited. To be honest, I thought it was, you know, I thought we were done. I thought we had enough songs. And then they said, hey, Laura, we have another song. I was like, oh, you know, because at the end, during the recording process, there's just less and less time left, right? And you kind of make a planning and you know you have time to make details for songs and stuff like that. So this is one of the songs that I think I just wrote like a little bit of the chorus, a little bit of the verse, and that's it. And the rest I actually finished in one of the hotel rooms. But yeah, Romana sent it to me and she said, hey, it would be cool. I think Larissa actually told me, probably they wrote it together at some point. And Larissa told me, hey, you have to start there. Who told me I have to start? Yeah, someone told me, hey, you have to start in a little bit before the, you know, the and normally it would and the it actually kind of starts, right? So there I was like, oh yeah, that's cool, let's do it. And for lyrics, lyric wise, I kind of wanted to go with the flow more, because normally I would have had like a whole list with things to choose from, but we were at the end of this whole process. And I didn't really have anything really left that I would have for ideas around this Countess Battery. That's the whole Dark Tower is about the first recorded serial killer, Countess Battery, who killed or tortured and killed maiden servants like crazy. And she could, because she was in, you know, in a powerful family there, ruling the lands, basically. And this, it was just kind of like a related song, you know, because I was like, okay, if you get so crazy that you start to torture and murder your servants, like, how does this happen? And I think, well, we do put ourselves to weird situations as humans, right? Because she maybe grew up in a weird environment where torture was not very unusual, let's just say that. A dark era where that was accepted, that people would just, yeah, instead of getting a sentence, they would get tortured, right? I mean, it doesn't really usually happen, at least not in the Netherlands. I'm not sure. But yeah, or in Switzerland, but yeah. So, yeah, I was thinking, you know, I thought it was cool, like Unleash the Beast. If you get crazy enough that it has to come out, Unleash the Beast. So that's what the song is about. Yeah.
And I mean, you girls come with some crazy ideas about the songs, honestly. I mean, even the title, Unleash the Beast, when I was watching the video and then I was listening to the song, I listened to the song like at least three times. In the video, I watched two times and I was like, yeah, I mean, when you have something inside of you, when I really release, you know, I was like, oh, now I get
it. Yeah, it can
message.
Also be a positive thing. It doesn't have to be killing people, yes.
Something that, you know, just, you know, one of those days that you just like, and nothing works. And then you just like, you have this beast inside of you trying to explode, and then I think that also could fit the song as well.
Yeah, also, yeah, I think indeed it's just nice that this song has a lot of energy, and yeah, it kind of feels like that, you know, like yeah, indeed, an explosion of
and
the beast. Yeah.
I mean, I like the video, you know. And the Dark Tower pretty much was the same thing as well. You girls got
it's both recorded by Dream Film Factory, and yeah, they did a great job. We love to work with them, and they were fun. They know how to make a cool vibe and cool shots in the video. So yeah, with especially the Dark Tower, it was lots of fun because it was for the first time for us that we also acted little parts. So we were actually
nice.
One of those maiden servants. Yeah, of the story. Yeah.
And the videos were recorded in Holland, where you come from, or in Switzerland.
Yeah, they were recorded actually in Germany, where the where that film company is. It was kind of
Oh.
easier for us to move there than all the gear to be moving somewhere else. So that's how we did it. And oh yeah, and of course, yeah, I have to note this, right? I didn't do that yet, but we did also decide now some versions of songs with also a version with Courtney. So we have that's special though, you know. We have that's a special.
Oh
Especially,
yeah,
yeah.
because Larissa, she is under maternity leave at the moment, right?
Exactly,
She's
yeah.
gonna have a kid, and then that's why Courtney just jump in to fill up for a while.
Yeah.
Nice. And how is it playing with Courtney?
Yeah, cool. It's fun. You know, she plays well and she's a nice person, and it's hard to keep up with her if she parties. You know, she unleashes the beast. Yeah, she knows
Nice.
how to do that.
Nice. And then also for her must be like kind of pain in the butt because she has to fly from the US to Europe because the whole band is based in Europe. And so it's just like back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. Oh my gosh.
It's always hard, and I think for for traveling, that this is why it's good that we have some shows always, you know, after each other, so it doesn't have to happen all the time. And she does have persons also that, you know, that can fill in for her in America, so that's good.
Oh,
Yeah.
that's really cool. And Laura, now talking about the whole album, The Dark Tower. When did you girls like, okay, let's sit down and start writing a new album? Was last year during tour or after the break?
Yeah, I mean, sitting down and doing a new album, I think that always happens, you know, pretty like a few months before we go to record. But yeah, the writing process started earlier. So just gathering ideas, you know, so not the whole songs, but just ideas. It kind of starts immediately after the last one, I guess. And then a few months later, I mean, not immediately the theme, I guess, but the theme came. Well, at least half a year before the recordings, you know. So there's enough time to come up with ideas, to write little titles down, or Romana always has musical ideas anyway, also. And I guess for all of us, it was pretty clear we wanted to have some, you know, some dark sounding music again. So this theme that we settled on also really fit this.
Nice.
Yeah.
And in the band, I mean, does everybody contribute in writing songs, or let's say
Yeah.
you write, or Roman does, or Larissa does? Who does what?
Yeah, I mean, most of it, I mean, yeah, the most of it happens musically happens by Romana, and most of it, yeah, 99% I do the lyrics, but everyone writes their own parts in the music, right? So
Nice.
Lala, together with everyone, they go in. I'm the one that doesn't really live close, so I usually don't really join that much, but they go into the rehearsal room, you know, if there's a bit of a song, and they use the bass that Romana wrote, so they use that to fill in the drums and the bass and solos and har solo harmonies and stuff like that. So everyone does do their plays their own part, but there's already a bit of a structure and a song, you know. There's a already start when that happens
Oh, I
usually.
see. Interesting. It's
Usually.
really interesting. So I mean it's a big family contribution. Each
Yeah.
girl doing like different stuff. And
Yeah.
Lara, who produced the album? How long it took like for you girls now to jump in the studio and record the whole thing? Because a lot of people think, I mean, people like not in the music industry, they think like recording an album you can do 1 2 days, and actually, it's not like this, it takes time.
Yeah, I mean, it does take time. I think it's always good to, you know, to come prepared to have some ideas and maybe some backup ideas if possible. Because in the studio, you have this song that you think is finished, but you know it can be better. But most of the times, and I think it's probably goes for most people, that it's really nice to have someone in the studio to have a fresh look on the music, a fresh air, basically. You know, and then figure out how to make it the best version, right? So you start to rearrange little parts and maybe try out little new ideas. So you don't really rewrite the whole song, but it's really easy if there's already a good bass Then it's always good for a producer. And in this case, it was Smear from Destruction and Pulver, mostly that really, Pulver, also the recording engineer, basically, that are really listening to it with a fresh ear, and they can just really point out, hey, let's try this, and then, you know, make it even better.
So these are the two producers, right, as you said, to help
yeah,
the
Smear,
guys.
Yeah.
And how long it took, like, you know, to get this whole thing done, like jump in the studio, record the whole album, and then to release later? I mean, the recording process.
The recording process itself is shorter. You know, you really try to prepare so you can record fast, because it's also expensive to go into a studio.
True.
But yeah, but there are things that you can try out. So there's always time to do little things. And I think, for actually the Dark Tower, the locker in the tower part didn't exist yet. You know, we wrote that in the studio because there should be something short, and I just couldn't really think of what would really fit. But then in the studio, you start also rearranging parts, you know, and then all of a sudden it makes sense to do it. You know what I mean? So
putting the pieces
together
here and there,
with the
and
producers, they said, "Oh, try this," and I you know, I have the lyrics in front of me, so maybe I shouted lock. I don't remember how it went exactly. And they're like, oh, let's do this, let's repeat it here, and maybe try. And then, yeah, basically with what you already have, you can easily try some stuff, you know. And then, yeah, that turned out to be pretty cool. So it's these things, fresh things also happen.
Nice. So pretty much, let's say, 1-2 weeks in the studio, everything was done.
Well, yeah, let me think. Well, a little bit longer, I guess, but something like that, because everyone does need, you do need to record it properly. It takes a lot of time. But something like that, a little bit more, I think.
And this studio was in Switzerland, Germany, or Netherlands?
Switzerland.
In Switzerland.
Yeah.
So everything's recorded there, and so you have to go all the way from Netherlands to Switzerland and then spend
time. Luckily I'm the only one, but yes, yeah.
Yeah,
so the rest is already there basically, but yeah, I do have to I stayed in a hotel really close because it was easiest, so I could start early in the morning and then just chill, you know, because there are long days.
It's true.
And you don't want to talk after that, you want to keep your voice good.
It's true.
So I was basically in my hotel room. Actually, yeah, finishing lyrics sometimes. For example, of Unleash the Beast, I finished it in the hotel room. Because, yeah, if you know how you want to do it, you can just come up with the lyrics quietly. You know, I didn't have to disturb
True.
anyone.
And just put the pieces all together.
Yes, yeah. Yeah,
nice. Yeah. Laura, since, like, there is a new album on the street, you know, 2023 tours going on this year.
I mean, they're not announced yet. We do have some things to announce, and there are some things in the works that we're still trying to put together. They're going to be probably after festival season, because we have a few release shows when the album comes out. So Switzerland, Germany, Belgium. And then, festival season starts. So, we do have cool things coming up. We're trying to go to the West Coast of America. And we're trying to get back to Latin America. And maybe some shows in Europe too. So, so let's see. But I can't really tell.
Yet. Still keep secret. It's a secret. Don't worry about it. Well, if you girls can return to South America, you know, do Brazil, Argentina, Chile, you know, other countries would be nice. And also, if you girls could, I don't know, play in Asia, also to be like, you know, could it be something also? Wow, you know.
Sorry, to play what?
To play in Asia, you know, China,
Asia.
Japan,
Ooh.
India, those places also.
That's on my to-do list, on my bucket list. I have to say bucket list. Yeah, I would love to, yeah.
So, I mean, the plans are more like right now is like this. Do the festival season, because it's very important to announce, promote the album. and then maybe South America as well.
Yeah, because we do have a show now also announced. It's in Mexico. Yeah, so it would be kind of logical. It would be a waste if we don't do some shows, right? So let's see.
True, true, true,
Yeah.
true. Laura, it was a huge, 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 huge pleasure talking to you and like finding out because since the last time I saw the band, it's been like almost a year. So I was like, oh, I have to find out what's going on in Burning Witches.
Yeah.
And then, boom, here we go. Here we are. Awesome. Thank you so much for
Yeah.
this interview.
Thank you so much for the interview also. Yeah. Hey, metalheads! This is Laura from Burning Witches. Thank you so much for your support and stay metal!